In part one of our instructional video series on the AEMC PowerPad 3 Model 8336, we explain how to set up, run, and save a recording session on the instrument. In part two, we now show you how to download the saved data to a computer and perform other tasks using AEMC's DataView software. This video assumes DataView with the PowerPad 3 control panel has been installed on your computer. DataView installation is the subject of a separate AEMC video. The DataView PowerPad 3 control panel is the interface for connecting with the Model 8336, downloading test results, and viewing the data on the screen. You can also use the control panel to set up recording sessions, view measurement data in real time, and configure the instrument. The Model 8336 communicates through a USB cable that comes with the product. Use this cable to connect the instrument to the computer. Next, turn the instrument on. Start the PowerPad 3 control panel by opening the DataView folder on your desktop and double-clicking the PowerPad 3 icon. When the control panel is open, click Instrument in the menu bar and select Connect an Instrument. The Connect an Instrument wizard dialog box appears. The name of the instrument is displayed in the instrument field. Click Next. The control panel connects to the instrument. When this is completed successfully, click Finish. The words Connected to Instrument appear in the control panel status bar. The control panel interface includes a navigation frame on the left and a data frame on the right. The content of the data frame depends on the selection in the navigation frame. For example, to view waveform data currently being measured by the connected instrument, click Real-Time Data in the navigation frame, then click Waveform. The waveform data appears in the data frame, in both tabular and graphical format. The buttons at the top of the data frame allow you to view this data several different ways. You can also view selected subsets of the data, freeze the updating of data on the screen, and display a phase or diagram. These and other features are described in the help system that comes with the control panel. A convenient feature of the control panel is its ability to configure the instrument from a computer. For example, you can save an instrument configuration and use it to configure one or more other instruments. This lets you quickly and easily set up multiple instruments with identical configurations. With the instrument connected, click Instrument in the menu bar and then select Configure. The Configure Instrument dialog box appears. This is the primary interface for changing settings on the instrument. The dialog box consists of 8 tabs for setting basic parameters, sensors and ratios, alarms, instrument display, and many other settings. You can also set up and schedule a recording session on the instrument, a topic we'll demonstrate next. To configure and run a recording session, click the Recordings tab of the Configure Instrument dialog box. This defines what data should be captured during recording sessions. You can create up to 4 different recording configurations. The Configuration Number Radio button field at the top of the tab selects the configuration. The other fields in this tab are as follows. Data to record displays all the available quantities that can be recorded. Select the quantity you want by checking its checkbox. You can select all the quantities by clicking the All button, or deselect all of them by clicking None. Harmonic values to record list available harmonic quantities. Select the ones you want to record by clicking the adjacent checkboxes. When you select a quantity, fields appear for entering the harmonic range. Allowable values are 0 through 50. You can also choose to record only odd harmonics by clicking the associated checkbox. Aggregation period defines the time interval over which measurements are aggregated. Select the appropriate period from the drop-down list. Options range from 1 second to 15 minutes. Note the Transients and Inrush tabs. These provide options for configuring the recording of transients and inrush events respectively. For our demonstration, we will leave these tabs unchanged. Next, click the Schedule tab. This controls when recording sessions start and stop. These can be general sessions that record the data specified in the Recordings tab. They can also be specific searches for transients, inrush, or alarm events. At the top of this tab is a read-only field that displays the electrical hookup, as defined in the Setup tab. The remaining fields on this tab are as follows. Instrument clock displays the current time of the instrument system clock. You can change this by clicking the Set button and completing the Date Time dialog box. Record Now, when checked, starts a recording immediately when the configuration is written to the instrument. When you select this option, the Duration field is displayed to allow you to set the length of the recording session. Options range from 30 minutes, the default, up to 8 weeks. Selecting Record Now also automatically checks the Use the Same Dates, Times, and Names for the recording and searches, and Include Recording options. The first of these options specifies that all recordings and searches start and stop at the same date and time, and also are stored under the same session name. When this option is selected and Record Now is deselected, the Starting Time and Ending Time fields appear, allowing you to define when the recording and searches start and stop. The session name can be up to 8 alphanumeric characters long. The remaining fields in this tab enable you to select and schedule a recording session, transient search, inrush search, or alarm search. If you deselect the Use the Same Dates, Times, and Names field, you can define a separate schedule and name for each recording or search. Note that if a recording session is already in progress or scheduled, the button End Trends Recording is displayed. You must click this button to end the active or scheduled recording before you can start or schedule a new one. When you have completed the Schedule tab, click OK. This saves the configuration and writes the settings to the instrument. The recording and searches will run on the instrument, either immediately or at the scheduled times. You can download recordings stored on the instrument. To do this, click Instrument in the menu bar and select Download Recorded Data. Then click Yes when asked to download all data. The Downloads dialog box appears, showing the progress of downloads from the instrument. When the downloads are complete, the instrument name appears under My Campaigns in the navigation frame, with all its downloaded recording sessions displayed in the data frame. Clicking the plus symbol next to the name displays folders containing recordings and searches. These include recordings, photographs, alarms, transients, and inrush searches. For example, in part 1 of this video series, we created a recording session called Video 3. Click this recording to display its measurements in the data frame and use the buttons at the top of the screen to view this data in a variety of ways. Note that you can also download data from the instrument by removing its SD card and inserting it into the computer. You can then download the recordings into the PowerPad 3 control panel directly from the card. This can save time when downloading a large amount of data. This procedure is the subject of a separate AEMC video. Another important feature of DataView is its ability to generate reports from recorded data. To demonstrate, we'll start by selecting a recording in the navigation frame. Click File in the Control Panel menu bar and choose Create DataView Report. DataView generates a report from the selected test data using the default report template. To save the report to the computer, click File when viewing the report, and then click Save, and specify a location for the saved report file. Note that DataView includes a number of features that enable you to customize your reports, displaying your test results for a wide range of users and purposes. These report generation features are described in detail in the DataView help. This video concludes our two-part series on setting up, recording, downloading, and creating reports from measurement data for the AEMC PowerPad 3 Model 8336. For more information about this instrument, please visit the AEMC website. And be sure to visit our YouTube channel for additional instructional videos about the many products offered by AEMC.